Welcome to Tech and Travel with NGT.
We will discuss about polarization of a light. First of all, let us see what do you mean by unpolarized light. This one is the source. If the electric field vectors are vibrating in all the direction, remaining perpendicular to direction of wave propagation, it is called unpolarized light. You can see here, vibration of electric field are in all direction. This can be represented by dot is perpendicular, vibration of electric field vector is perpendicular to plane of paper, and arrow is direction, vibration of electric field vector in parallel to plane of paper. So these are superposed here each other. This type of a light is called unpolarized light. Now, what do you mean by a polarized light? If a light beam which has vibration of electric field vector in one plane is called polarized light. You can see here, vibration of electric field vectors are parallel to each other and remaining perpendicular to direction of wave propagation. So all electric field vector are vibrating in a particular plane. This type of vibration of electric field vector produces polarized light. Okay, now you see here A, B, C, D. A, B, C, D is called plane of polarization. Why it is so? The plane ABCD contains vibration of plane polarized light. It is called plane of vibration. Okay, you can see here, these are electric field vectors. These electric field vectors are vibrating in which type of plane? ABCD. So this type of a plane is called plane of vibration. The plane perpendicular to this plane of vibration, it is called, you can say, A, B, C, D. It is plane of vibration. The plane perpendicular to this plane of vibration, it is called plane of polarization. So P, Q, R, S. It is perpendicular to the plane of vibration. A plane P, Q, R, S is perpendicular to plane of vibration is called plane of polarization. Okay. Now, what is the intensity of this plane polarized light? Intensity of plane polarized light is given by I equal to I0 cos square theta. So what is theta? Let me tell you. This one is a tourmaline plate. Okay. When the light beam of light is incident on this tourmaline plate. Okay. Here electric field is vibrating in all the direction. This one is the optic axis or crystalline axis of tourmaline plate. What is the use of working of this tourmaline plate? Only this electric field vector passes through this tourmaline plate which are parallel to this type of a optic axis. So these are the vertical vibration of the electric field vector are passes through this tourmaline plate according to this figure. Clear? So in this way we can say the output of electric field vector are remaining parallel to each other and perpendicular to direction of wave propagation. In this way, we produce plane polarized light with help of tourmaline plate. Working of tourmaline plate is to produce plane polarized light. You can see this electric field vector, I mean vibration of electric field vector are perpendicular to this optic axis does not pass. It will be blocked here. In this way, we can get plane polarized light here. Now, you can see if we place again a second tourmaline plate, it is called analyzer. What is the working of analyzer? Working of analyzer is to rotate. When you rotate this tourmaline plate, what will happen? You can analyze whether the light is plane polarized, whether the light is circular polarized, whether the light is ellipsoidal polarized light. So in this way we can analyze the nature of light with help of same tourmaline plate or same Nicol prism. So this is called as an analyzer. The working of polarizer is to convert unpolarized into polarized light. Working of analyzer is to analyze whether the light is polarized or not. If it is polarized, when it is plane polarized light, whether it is circular polarized light, and so on. When you rotate this one is figure 1, number 1 position, in number 2 position, suppose what will happen if you rotate this analyzer? Whenever you rotate this analyzer, you can see, okay, then the intensity of electric field vector or polarized light will be reduced. A stage will come when the axis of analyzer and axis of this polarizer becomes 90 when you rotate this. When this becomes 19, then you can say there is a no plane polarized light. The intensity will be equal to 0. In this way, intensity will be proportional to intensity of plane polarized light. According to Malus law, it is equal to I 0 cos square theta. I 0, it is the initial intensity of light. Okay, so in this way we produce polarized light with help of polarizer or tourmaline plate. Now let me say, polarization by double refraction. Okay, what do you mean by double refraction? You can get two refracted ray from one incident ray. The phenomena is called double refraction. Suppose this one is a calcite crystal. It is a double refracting material. This one is unpolarized light. Okay, it is vibrating in all the direction. These are the vibrating in parallel to plane of paper, and these are vibrating dots indicates the electric field vector vibrating perpendicular to plane of paper. I mean, this is unpolarized light. When it is incident at this calcite crystal, what will happen? It will be divided into extraordinary ray. It will be divided into also ordinary ray. We will get two type of ray. For E rays, vibration of electric field vector as parallel to the plane of paper. In this way, we can get polarized light here. It is called extraordinary ray. Here, vibration of electric field vector for ordinary ray is perpendicular to the plane of paper. It is indicated by dot here. Okay, now, why it is called ordinary ray? Why it is called extraordinary ray? Ordinary ray is obeys Snell's law. And velocity of, we can say, the velocity of ordinary ray, okay, it is equal in all direction. So, let me say, wavefront followed by ordinary ray, it is circular because its velocity is equal in equal direction. Okay, now, for extraordinary ray, we can say the velocity of electric field vector are different in different direction. It does not obey Ohm's law.
Snell's law.
For negative crystal, velocity of extraordinary ray is greater than velocity of ordinary ray according to this Snell's law. You can see this one, R2 is the refractive index. Sorry, R2 is the refracting angle for extraordinary ray. R1 is the refracting angle for ordinary ray. So, mu E equal to sin I divided by R2. Mu O equal to sin I divided by R1. You know from figure that R2 is greater than R1. That means mu O is greater than mu E. Why it is so? Because VE is greater than VO. Because mu and V are inversely proportional to each other. You can see this formula. Okay. So in this way, in calcite crystal, what is the thing? The refractive index of ordinary ray is greater than refractive index of extraordinary ray, and velocity of extraordinary ray is greater than velocity of ordinary ray. So for extraordinary ray, you can see that its velocity is different in different direction. So whenever you draw the wavelet or wavefront, it will be ellipsoidal. Okay, wavefront for extraordinary ray is ellipsoidal, and wavefront for ordinary ray is circular like this. And you can see this ellipsoidal wavefront of extraordinary ray is outside this circular wavefront. Why it is so? Because VE is greater than VO. VE is greater than VO. So it is outside that. Okay. So you must say that. What do you mean by optic axis of a crystal? Optic axis of a crystal is the direction in which the velocity of ordinary ray and velocity of extraordinary ray becomes equal. So at this point, at optic axis, okay, at this point both wave fronts should be touched here and here. Okay, so it is called optic axis. Now, let me say, you can draw wave front according to Eugene's principle. How it is so? According to Eugene's principle, when a ray of light is incident on doubly refracting material, what will happen? Okay, this will produce a point on a surface, okay, behave as a secondary source. And this secondary source produce wavefront for ordinary ray and wavefront for extraordinary ray. So vibration of electric field vector for extraordinary ray is parallel to the plane of paper. Vibration of ordinary ray is perpendicular to the plane of paper. Vibration of electric field vector, you can see here from these, the wavefront of extraordinary ray is ellipsoidal, the wavefront of ordinary ray is circular like this. So in this way we can produce the wavefront with help of Huygens theory.